Hey everybody, welcome to the third episode in our series of Digital Identity on Blockchain Central. Today, we're focusing on autonomous vehicles, or AVs. Every month, we publish three videos, two in-depth explorations into the fascinating world of blockchains, and one video where we summarize the most important events of the previous month. If you want to stay up to date with our content, be sure to click that subscribe button and hit the little bell to always get notified when we drop a new video. Also, please be sure to check out our Medium blog at medium.com/@blockessence. See the link in the description box for details. You can also follow me on Instagram at TheBlueMantic to stay up to date with my other projects. Now let's talk AVs. For quite some time now, the automotive industry has been quoted as a potential beneficiary of DLT technologies. We've heard rumors of multiple companies testing various blockchain solutions to tackle issues ranging from supply chain management, fleet management, data processing, to simply unlocking cars from an app. But in our opinion, it is the field of autonomous vehicles that DLT will prove most impactful. First of all, let's define AVs. Let's look at their use cases and see why everyone is so excited about this technology. Autonomous vehicles, or self-driving cars, are vehicles capable of sensing the environment and moving safely with little to no human input. They use a wide array of technologies that help them perceive their surroundings, including radar, LiDAR, sonar, GPS, audiometry, and inertial measurements. According to a classification issued by the Society of Automotive Engineers, SAE, there are six levels of driving automation. These range from systems that only issue warnings without controlling the vehicle to solutions in which no human intervention is required. It is the latter that is considered to be the holy grail of AVs. Of course, large-scale adoption of such vehicles is still sometime removed pending serious legislative moves, but many people, including Tesla's Elon Musk, went on record saying that it is human-operated vehicles that will eventually be banned. The AV technology, when widely implemented, has a huge potential for disruption in multiple areas. These include shipping, human transportation, and vehicle ownership. It is well documented that Uber is one company whose long-term survival depends almost entirely on the adoption of AVs. Another field that will likely benefit the adoption of AVs is car sharing. It is likely that car sharing and ride sharing services will be merged when the technology is implemented. Believe it or not, according to a study conducted by the World Economic Forum, the main reason why end users are interested in AVs is parking. Having your car drive away on its own is certainly a way to avoid having to park it. So what roles do blockchains have in the development of AV technology? There are a few fundamental applications. The first one is the management of vehicle testing data. The solution is currently being explored by Toyota in partnership with MIT. The second use case, which is more typically associated with blockchains, is the management of car and ride sharing transactions. Another good usage would be the reliable and trustless monitoring of car data for insurance purposes. It is important to note that all typical Internet of Things applications are also very relevant to all vehicles, including AVs. A good example of a company that truly embraces blockchains in the development process is automotive giant Volkswagen. Last year, they announced a partnership with IOTA aimed at developing the so-called digital car pass technology. The solution's primary function is collecting and communicating car data, but it could also make it easier to pay parking fees and tolls. IOTA is also involved in partnership with Jaguar Land Rover. Their mutual goal is to develop a smart wallet that could enable the vehicles to earn money and pay for selected services. Other possible use cases for the data are transfer or even file exchange, enabling a convenient interface between the car and the other IoT devices. These are very promising areas for development, but in our opinion, the real promise of DLT lies within the data sharing and digital identity. Let's break this down. It goes without saying that developing autonomous technologies requires an insane amount of testing. Real-life simulations and scenarios can't really be tested inside computers and need to happen in the physical realm. This can get expensive, time-consuming, and especially when it comes to actual road testing, requires multiple permits and authorizations. These obstacles significantly limit the amount of data each company can obtain and process. Of course, as most car manufacturers are in fierce competition with each other, research cooperation and free data exchange is not really an option. Now imagine a solution in which each piece of data is cataloged, labeled, and permanently and immutably branded by the company that generated it. That is, of course, something that can easily happen on the blockchain. Then, all the data is stored in a data silo and can later be traded between different companies in an open market. This can significantly speed up the development of AV technology and facilitate cooperation between competitors. What's more, such solutions can be applied to many different fields of research, accelerating the development in multiple areas of technology. The fact that such data would be stored in a distributed or decentralized fashion can serve as an added incentive to pursue this vision. This is currently being tested by a Mobility Open Blockchain Initiative, or Mobi. The project already includes many prominent members, with a few big brands from the automotive industry such as BMW, Ford, GM, Honda, and Renault. From the blockchain space, IOTA, Consensus, and VeChain are also present. According to the website, Mobi's mission is making mobility services more efficient, affordable, greener, safer, and less congested by promoting standards and accelerating the adoption of blockchain, distributed ledger, and relating technologies in the mobility industry. It goes without saying that such a visionary solution will present at least a few significant challenges. Here, the fundamental issue is the fact that blockchains don't work very well as high-volume databases. They're slow. They have redundancies, and various consensus mechanisms can be effort or energy intensive. Since the development of AVs generates very significant amounts of data, for this to work, there needs to be a way for distributed databases to interact with the blockchain. We're sure that a sustainable solution is on the way, and we'll be watching the development closely. Another possible blockchain solution that clearly depends on digital identities is the issue of tagging AVs inside a bigger network. The great promise of self-driving cars is the possibility of practically eradicating accidents and traffic jams. Imagine a network of AVs in which every single vehicle is at all times aware of the position of other vehicles on the network. Cars could be crossing intersections at the cruising speeds without needing for stopping. Sounds like science fiction. Well, if the human factor was eliminated from the equation, the only circumstance in which an accident would occur would be caused by a glitch or a hacker. In order for this to work, every single vehicle would need to be precisely labeled and identified on the network. Additionally, such labeling would have to be non-fungible and completely tamper-proof. If that sounds familiar, it's because that's precisely what blockchains are really good at. It is important to note that, in a distributed system, a single point of failure is additionally eliminated. This further reduces the risk of an accident. Of course, at this stage, this is a purely hypothetical solution, and there are numerous obstacles that would need to be overcome for this to be real. One such obstacle is, as usual, scalability. The network would need to be able to process a big number of vehicles and seamlessly add new units. The second challenge has to do with processing speeds. A network like that would have to process millions of transactions per second and have redundancies in place to accommodate any glitches without causing an accident. So, that's it for this episode on digital identity. In our opinion, AV applications are some of the most promising DLT solutions out there, with a promise of real-life implementations and a significant value added. We'll of course monitor all developments and keep you posted. Subscribe and always be up to date. In the fourth and final episode of this series, we'll cover digital identity for people and look into the potential applications for voting. Before you go, please note that this content neither represents financial, legal, or tax advice, nor is it supposed to be understood or interpreted as solicitation to buy or sell any securities, coins, or tokens. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe to Blockchain Central to never miss a beat. Also, check out our blog, the link in the description below. You can also follow me on Instagram at TheBlueMantic to catch up with my other projects. See you in the next one.